Hey guys, my name is Jason with Non-Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're going to be crushing up some oyster shells for one of the biggest shellfish processors on the West Coast. And these guys are interested in making a product out of their waste shell. They've got literal mountains of this stuff sitting around on their property, and they're looking at using some of our crushers, the jaw crusher or the hammer mill here behind me, to turn this waste product into a revenue stream for them. They've got industries such as the chicken feed industry. They've got fertilizer industry, soil amendment stuff. They've got people looking at doing landscape mulch with it. So there's a bunch of stuff they can do with these oyster shells, but they've got to get them crushed up to the right size first. So let's get our crushers going, and we'll see if we can make a product they can use. So these are oyster shells they sent to us, but in the past we've done oyster shells, we've done clams, we've done mussels, we've done crab shells and lobster shells. So this is a really, really big industry, actually, this crushing up of these waste shells. This company is after a product that looks something like this. I believe this is for chicken feed. They use this to supplement the chicken diet for calciums for their eggshells. And so this is what we're going for. But the problem with hammer mills and jaw crushers is they're great at sizing a top size, so like a half inch minus or a three quarter minus, but they're not good at sizing on the back end or the downside. So we can get a product that's no bigger than this, but there's definitely gonna be some smaller stuff in there. So let's look at some of the screens we're gonna use today, and the hammer mill in particular. I've got two different options. This is a 3/4 inch hole here. If that doesn't work or that gets too big a size, I've got a half inch slot. And I can go smaller, I can go 1/4 inch or, you know, holes or slots or squares, whatever they need. But these are the two I had on hand on to run their sample. And my thought is that even if you get a little bit oversized through these holes, most of it is going to be in this size range that we're looking for. And you don't want to overcrush it. And the finer you get, the more fines you're going to have. So I would rather try and put that bell curve of sizes out of the hammer mill right at the peak, right at this peak, which is going to be a little bit oversized, a little bit undersized, but most of it in this range. So that's what we're going to try today. We're going to start here with this 6x10 jaw crusher, just because it's easy. I can just plug it in and crush some shells through it. I think they're going to be mostly oversized, but we're going to try it and see what that looks like. If that doesn't work, we're going to move over to the 16x12 hammer mill here, and I'll change out the screen. I'll show you that whole process. And then we can run our samples through the two different screens and see how that works. First thing I'm going to do is get the hammer mill screen in. And I got to disconnect all the hoses because we're going to run this sample without water. So I'm going to disconnect the hoses. I'm going to take the four bolts that hold the lid on off. And then we'll lift the lid off the forklift, and I'll show you what the inside looks like and how to change that screen. Well, they have the lid off now. I wanted to show you what the inside here looks like while I got it off. And looking up in there, there's the feed chute. And we've got replaceable armor all the way around for wear surfaces. These two up here get worn the most, actually. Side armor here that is all bolt-on and replaceable. And as you can see, it comes really pretty clean. I mean, I was running this yesterday with some gold ore in it. And it's not like there's a bunch of sand and muck and stuff all stuffed up in there. So it comes pretty clean. Here's the rotor assembly of the mill. This is right here is the wear surface of the hammers. So you can see that. These are fairly new. I've probably run maybe a couple tons through here. But you can see they don't wear very fast. I mean, I'm going to get several tons. I mean, several. I'm going to get 20 or 30 tons out of these set of hammers before they wear out. And oftentimes what will happen is the leading edge here wears down and rounds real bad. And then you can take the hammers and turn them around and you get a whole nother surface on this side. So you run for 15 or 20 tons, turn the hammers around and get another 10 tons out of them. There's the screen. It wraps all the way down underneath and comes up to a stop here. So I'm just gonna take that screen. I got to loosen the armor bolts. There's lower armor here. So I'm going to loosen those. And then I'm just going to push the screen out backwards. It rolls out. And then I'll roll a new screen in, bolt the armor in, put the lid back on, and we'll be ready to run. All right. Well, now I got the screen started out. and I can just use this pry bar to pry it the rest of the way out. This is a way easier job with two people, but you just kind of work it up out of there. And that screen will just roll out. I got to get with the hammer and bang around on it a little bit, but I'm going to roll that screen out, and then I'll show you how to roll the other one in. There we go. I've got the hold screen, and we're going to slide it right in there. There we go. Just get it wrapped around, and we'll get it banged in there, and we'll be off to the races here. Okay, our screen's in there. We're all set to go. I don't know if I mentioned earlier, but these are chrome iron hammers. They're about 20% chrome, and they're extremely abrasion resistant. So that's what we use for general aggregate crushing or oyster shells, stuff like that, glass, recycling glass. And then for the electronics and the PCBs and the recycling and stuff like that, we use manganese steel hammers for those. All right, well, we got the jaw crusher and the hammer mill sample run, and we're gonna start with the jaw crusher. This stuff actually came out a lot finer than I thought it would. There's a lot of powder in here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this stuff, and I've got three different size screens here. I've got a half inch, a quarter inch, and an eighth inch. And so we're gonna screen the shells through these three different fractions, three different screens, and see what percentage of each size we get. Here's the screen results from our jaw crusher sample. And starting over here with the largest, this is the half inch plus. And it's really pretty nice looking stuff. That would make great landscape mulch. Then moving over here, this is the half inch to quarter inch. And that is also really nice looking stuff. Again, landscape mulch probably. I'm sure there's an application for that. This is the quarter inch to eighth inch. And I think this is probably the closest that we came to the customer sample. I'll show you that here in just a second. But this is kind of what they were shooting for, I think. So that's that pile. And then this is the eighth inch minus, so it goes eighth inch all the way down to powder. And that's really nice looking stuff. And I don't know if that's like a fertilizer product, soil amendment, you know, add it to compost or whatever. So there's the four piles. And amazing to me, again, I'm really surprised how well the jaw crusher did, but all these piles are about the same volume, roughly, I believe. And so you get a really nice, even distribution of sizes when using the jaw crusher. In my hand here is the sample set from the customer. And there's the pile of stuff that's quarter to an eighth. So I think it's pretty much the same stuff. And here's the screen results from our hammer mill with 3/4 inch holes. And you can see right away that there's hardly anything up here on the 1/2 inch plus side. And the most material is down here on the 1/8 inch minus. So I mentioned earlier about that bell curve, and this is a good representation of that bell curve from the jaw crusher. It's like it went up and was plateaued across all four sizes. Whereas with the hammer mill, the bell curve has been shifted over to the right. So there's, it kind of ramps up here, and then you have the most volume in the fine stuff. I don't know if that makes sense to anybody, but hopefully you understand what I'm trying to explain. But again, this is the same size fractions, 1/2 inch plus, 1/2 to 1/4, 1/4 to 1/8. This is the range that the customer was looking for. And then 1/8 inch minus. I am not gonna put this screen in there because I need to talk with the customer first and figure out if they had a preference. Would they rather have more fine material or would they have more coarse material? Because this is the finer screen out of the two, the hammer mill screens. The 3/4 inch holes is gonna give a bigger product. And with this screen, you're gonna actually get more and more fine stuff. So we've got our hopper full of oyster shells here. They're all mucky and gooey and wet. We're gonna turn the vibrator on. We're gonna feed out this chute here into the spiral conveyor. We're gonna go up into the hammer mill. We're gonna add about 2 or 3 gallons a minute to the hammer mill to help flush it out. And it's gonna discharge through the 3/4 inch hole into the barrel. So here's the results from our oyster test. And we ran about a cubic meter or a cubic yard in about 10 or 12 minutes to give you an idea of the volume. This was a 3/4 inch screen, round holes. Those are the results from the oyster shells through the jaw crusher and the hammer mill. And you saw that actually the jaw crusher did a pretty decent job getting the stuff crushed down through and a very nice even distribution of sizes. Whereas the hammer mill, even with that 3/4 inch hole, had a lot of the stuff was pushed over to that fine range, that 1/4 inch minus, 1/8 inch minus. So I don't know, I'm not a shellfish guy. I don't know if there's a product for all different sizes or what, But if there's someone out there that has some information on this, please leave us a comment down below so we can all learn from this and figure out kind of what the best use for these shellfish, this oyster shell waste is. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you're looking for any of these products, you can give us a call or shoot us an email, and you can find that in the description below. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.